Can you hear in the back?
Stand up.
If you shut the hell up, you might be able to hear.
Stand up.
I'm sorry.
Can't hear you.
Monsignor has his head down, go home, by the way. Candy, seriously, can you hear in the back? Because we have some very special speakers tonight, and I don't want you to miss any.
Speak up.
I guess we'll start with Jerry Knowles, our representative.
Stand up.
Jerry is also representing Senator Arbel's office. Senator could be with us tonight.
Thank you very much. Everybody hear me? How are we doing, okay? I apologize. Usually we come and have the dinner, my wife and I, but we're babysitting tonight. We have my two-year-old grandson and my six-year-old grandson. And by the time we take them back tomorrow morning, we will not have had one drink, but we will look as bad as many of you guys are going to be on the air tonight. But it is always a pleasure to be here, and I appreciate the opportunity to go first. I will tell you that you guys really can be very proud of what you do, not only in terms of the services that you provide to your community, but in leading the way in terms of your merger, in terms of the three companies up here coming together. I can't tell you how important that is to the fire service. And we need to do that. And it needs to, I tell a lot of people all the time, it needs to come from within. It needs to be something that you guys want to do. But I think that you guys see ahead of time that it's something that you have to do. If we're going to survive as volunteers, it's something that you have to do, because it's just impossible to have four fire companies in Tomaqua and three fire companies up in this area. And you guys are really trailblazers, and I commend you for being trailblazers in that arena. I will tell you that we have legislation, and for those of you who don't think, we are listening when you guys talk to us. When you come to us with ideas, we're listening. I have a bill that passed in the last session of the legislature. Unfortunately, it died in the Senate, but I've introduced it already, and that is legislation that when you guys merge, you will continue to get your $12,000-$15,000 grants in perpetuity, is the way that I want to go. Now, the last session, we had to really go from 5 to 10 years. But that means so much, because in your case, as a fire company, we're talking about $30,000. $30,000 that you would lose. So we want to be certain that this would be an incentive for fire companies like you to merge. It would be an incentive, because that $45,000 that each of you are currently getting, $15,000, well, that $45,000 would continue to come to you forever. And $45,000 is a lot of money in a fire company. That's a lot of hoagies, and it's a lot of... And by the way, I gotta tell you, man, oh man, I stopped by Super Bowl Sunday, and that's the best damn stromboli I ever had. That was good stuff. And you can tell by looking that when it comes to food, I know my food. But that's a lot of stromboli when you talk about $45,000. So maybe we'll call that the Lesko bill, okay? He came to me and he said, you know, this is silly. You're exactly right. It's not right to punish somebody for doing something that's good. But I want to certainly commend each and every one of you for the job that you do. I ran actively for about 35 years in Tomaqua. You can attest to that. Getting too old now, but my heart and soul will always be in the volunteer fire service. That's really my passion in the House of Representatives. Something we've got to do meaningful stuff. We've got to do some meaningful stuff here in the water. Is this yours? I don't want to walk out of here with anything. See, you know, you really hammered this guy, didn't you, Lee? Very good. I think it's water. But, no, we need, in the legislature, we need to do meaningful things that are going to genuinely help you. And by meaningful, it can't be just a $10 registration plate. It's got to be, for example, it's got to be something like, if you have a young family, maybe we help you with your health care. If you're going to go to college, maybe we help you with your tuition. I just think, I'm talking about ways like that. And I know that when I talk, local officials kind of roll their eyes. And I say, yeah, but you know, you don't get it. You've already got a bargain, and it's not going to be quite the bargain that it is. But you guys work on budgets. I don't have to tell you. If we had to pay for fire service in these little communities, I mean, your taxes would just be through the roof. They would be worse than what they are. And I continue to remind mayors and councilmen and township supervisors that the numbers are dwindling, and we need to do whatever we can do to get new people in. And I'm really proud of you guys, because you've got a lot of good young people here, and I certainly commend you for that. But we got to do something to recruit and something to retain. I think retaining is just as important, because I know when I get into the fire service back in the early 70s, we had about 15 guys that came in, and I ran until about 7 years ago. And when I left, there were everybody was gone by the time I left. And over the course of time, they get married, they have kids, and they find other interests that they have to work on. But, having said that, thank you. Do you want me to give these out now, or do you want, huh?
No,
later. Later. Listen, I can't thank you enough for what you do. Have a good night. Stay safe. Have fun, but don't have too much fun. Right, Trooper? Don't have too much fun. I know I'm talking too long, but you gave me the mic. I got to tell you, you'll get a kick out of this, Trooper.
Oh, boy.
In my career, no, this is good stuff. In my career, we've had a lot of people come to Harrisburg. We've had opportunity to have our pictures taken with, you know, with governors and with football players and with movie stars. I'm not exaggerating. And I never really got into that stuff. But 2 weeks ago, we had the five U.S. Marshals that took down that canary up in the Poconos. And I got to tell you, I went out and I had a picture taken with them. I blew it up for like a 2x3 picture. That's 2 feet by 3 feet. And then they signed it was a wanted poster, and it basically said, well, captured. And each of them signed it. And it just was something that... as a former cop, many years ago I worked as a full-time cop in Tamaqua. That was just so special to me, but I will tell you, I was talking to those guys, and when they talked about the Pennsylvania State Police, they said, hey, look, it's luck and timing. We're the guys that were there. But he said, I got to tell you, you guys got a hell of a state police organization here. And he said, make no mistake about it, they were a large part of us being able to get this son of a gun. I was going to say something. Who's the Monsignor?
Right here.
Monsignor, God bless you. Have a good night.
Don't go in the bathroom, that would not be smart.
Pick the right one.
Next up to speak is our two commissioners, Gary Hess and George Halkovich. I know you find this hard to believe, but I'm keeping this very professional, and you hear what they're doing. Well, hopefully I can last.
You doubt it.
You wait till they leave and talk about it.
George, keep an eye on Gary at the table.
By the way, Frank, Emily, stand up a second. Okay.
Emily's going to come up and teach Frank how to do hip-hop. What do you think about that? Frank, have you done hip-hop before?
He's done a lot of hip-hop.
Emily, did your mother tell you years ago don't talk to strangers?
I know, you should talk to Frank. No. First of all, I just wanted to thank you for having us. We're so happy to be here. And just to give you a little history of where we've been today, started out meeting in Pottsville, had a spelling bee at Blue Mountain High School in Oryxburg, then went to St. Clair, then went out to Williams Valley out in Tower City for a county band concert. Left there, went to Marks Hall, saw Shenandoah on a city or Mono area play. Left there, went to Landingville for the soccer scholar athlete. Left there, came here. We're going Gary's daughters in a concert in Pottsville. I'm hitting place in Frackville, and also then going down, we're going to the Oryxburg Library event down at the Country Club. And one thing I have to say, and I'm so proud to be with two fine gentlemen as my fellow county commissioners, is Frank Stottemeyer, who's actually on county business right now. He heads up the insurance committee for all the counties throughout the state, and he's away right now, or otherwise he would be here. And also Gary Hess, who, you know, comes to everything. We're just very honored to be here. One of the things that, and I want to give, you know, McAdoo, Klein Township, so many kudos. When we were talking about, and something near and dear to you guys, the 911 project, our narrowbanding, and our radio project, you know, one of the areas that we were most concerned about was this area. And, you know, again, even though we didn't do it up front when we should have, we put together a committee of firefighters, emergency management people, emergency ambulance, and also police officers to come together to give us recommendations. Bob is on the committee, and they have done such an outstanding job. And you know, one of the things I will tell you about what we've done as commissioners and what I'm proud of, a lot of people talk about getting things done. We do get things done. And that's the thing that is so important, and I give my fellow commissioner Gary Hess and Frank Stottemeyer all the credit in the world, because we do want to get things done. It's tough sometimes, but we have to make those tough decisions. We are so honored to be here. This is such a special area. Gary and I drove up here together and just talking about how great this community is and what you bring to this area. What your municipal officials do, your township officials, you have great people. Your state legislator, he's like a nice guy. Jerry, you're really a nice guy. No?
I'm not buying it, George.
You're not buying it? Hey, we tried. Everybody heard that. No. But again, we're honored to be here. We're honored to be among great volunteers. And I also not only thank the volunteers, but I thank your families for allowing you to have the time away from the family that you are helping your neighbors and your friends. That means so much. So again, I say thank you. God bless. I'm going to turn it over to my fellow commissioner, Gary Hess.
Thank you, George. I don't know if there's anything else to say after Jerry and George. What else is to say? Frank, where's the box you usually stand on?
Right, if you can stand down on your hands and knees, yeah. Gary can stand up there, it'd be great.
I always look up to you. You need to stand on your box. But anyway, just to add on what George said, and again, with all the things that were going on today, I said to George, I said, out of one thing that we definitely needed to come up here this evening. And we were so gracious when, especially myself and George, got elected 3 years ago, that you always send an invite to come up here. And it's always has been and always will be an enjoyable evening. And we thank you for the opportunity to come and share in your past year's accomplishments. And again, those accomplishments is out there protecting the safety of everyone else out there. And sometimes is when that alarm goes off and you go out and you leave your family, And that's the whole thing, the important thing is that you come home to your family and to do that. And that's what the importance of all of this is about. And especially with making sure everyone out there, and especially on the radios and all of that, it was an important thing to do. And the training is second to none. And again, to being involved. And also being the front runner of looking to the merger. Because again, those are things. And you know what? It's a hard decision. Because a lot of fire companies, you look across this county, have been formed out of, you know, your father, your grandfather, and so forth. And that's what it is. It's family. And this is a big family. It's an extension of your regular family that if you ever need help. And that's what firefighting's about. And the whole thing is never leave a brother behind. That you're always there, ready to pick one up when they're ready to fall down and whatever.
Or a sister.
Or a sister, yes. Yeah. Yes, definitely. But again, continue. We're very proud, especially as county commissioners. And our forefront is public safety and to make sure that all our citizens are kept safe. And again, we could not do it without the outstanding work that all of you do and contribute to that each and every day. And always, when that alarm rings, you're always there. And hopefully we can get some young people instilled that we need to carry on what you've carried on for so many years. So again, thank you for the honor. We appreciate it. And enjoy the evening. Thanks again. This is the bad part, turning that mic back.
We do have some special guests, brothers and sisters from the Hazleton Fire Department, West Hazleton Fire Department, Hazle Township, and their tiny chief. And APTS is here. Thank you for joining us tonight. I'd like to bring to the podium now my dear friend, Mayor Steve Hawley.
This is a surprise.
I told you all at the beginning I was going to keep you here.
I wouldn't go up there if I were wrong.
Thank you, Frank. Once again, it's always a pleasure to be here, and it is truly a community that does come together. We all have our differences. We have our differences in our own homes, but we work a lot. We do it here. And one thing I'd like to say about the Mackinac Fire Company, I'm very pleased that all three are going to join together. That'll make us stronger. I just hope we're going to keep the picnic down at the Keystone. I don't know. Are we doing that, guys?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, okay. But it's really nice that we're all coming together, and hopefully, I don't know if I should say this out loud here, but I'm going to anyhow. Maybe we can look into maybe joining the police force as well. I don't know. Anybody in favor of that?
Yay!
We can all work together. I mean, even if we join the police force together as mayor in charge of the police, that kind of stuff I'd put right to the side and let them work it out.
Let's go to the streets
department
too,
there, Mayor. Well, yeah. Yeah. Absolutely. Now, I would like to mention one thing about that. People do complain about the potholes. They're everywhere. And they are. But we have to stop and think now for a minute, truthfully. We live in Northeast PA. It is the winter time. The plows come down the street, they're going to scrape a little bit. If you're going to put salt on there, it's going to open up. It happens. It's not just this area. I drive down to Job Corps every single day and they take 309. Believe me, it's all over the place. You know? So we have to keep in mind that that's just the way it is, you know. What it boils down to is the character of a person and everybody making sure you're safe and healthy at home. That's what really counts. This is just a part of life here. The road to success is always under construction. We all know that, right? But, I don't know, could I take my ears off? I know he's gonna get me at the end here. I seen him running to the bathroom about 3 or 4 times. And I'll keep it clean. Well, maybe not. And I said, Frank, what's going on? He said, well, I've been feeling good lately. He says, I think I might have diarrhea. He said, it runs in the family. I said, no, I think it runs in your genes. uh, But all kidding aside, it truly is a pleasure, and I'm very pleased to be the mayor this time, and I'm glad that it's all come together. These are all there. When it comes down to it, you guys are there, and you do a great job, and I thank you for that, and I pray that we continue to do it, to go on. Thank you.
Tommy, I understand how you felt last year when they were picking on you and you were like the celebrity roast. Now, you all know I haven't said anything to anybody. I'm keeping it very professional and they're all taking jabs. I might have to come back next year to get even. Maybe. Klein Township? Anybody from Klein Township?
Good evening, everybody. On behalf of the Board of Supervisors for Klein Township, Carmen Carey in the back and myself, Nick Seichel didn't make it tonight. I want to thank everybody from the fire company for inviting us and inviting our wives. In thinking about tonight, I was thinking what changed over the last 12 months. Two things came to mind for me, and one of them is we just renewed our fire protection contract. And I want to thank Matt and Bobby for working with us on that. It's not that we just needed to go ahead and renew the contract, but it was important to us that we have people that we can count on. And I'm going to say something my mother-in-law always says when she hears a siren go off or sees the ambulance go by, that it doesn't matter what the weather is, it doesn't matter what time of the night it is, but when you make the call, Bobby Leshko and the boys will be there. And I think when you hear that, it's a pretty good sentiment for the whole community, how much confidence that we have in you. And the other thing was the proposed merger. Over the last year, we heard some things about that. And I just want to go ahead and, you know, just from my personal opinion, say I really salute all the elected officials at the fire company, Bobby, Matt, all the officers from all the fire companies, for having the courage to step up, do what they feel is right to go ahead and protect this community for years to come. Change a lot of time is hard, and Bobby talked to us a couple times over the last 12 months, seeing some things in the paper about it. Sometimes it's hard to get people to go ahead and make changes. They're used to old ways, but it doesn't matter if you're a township, a borough, or here in this case, a fire company. Sooner or later, you need to make some changes for the good of the community, the good of the organization. So good luck with that, and we're behind you, and thank you for everything the fire company has done for the township, all the communities throughout the year, and just have a safe year, and thank you.
Bob, you want to come up for a few minutes?
I'm up here just to introduce the officers of the McAdoo Fire Company and McAdoo Ambulance at this time. Starting with the McAdoo Fire Company, our president, Matt Sapulich. So as I say your name, if you could stand up. Just to... Vice President, Ronald Leshko. Secretary, Ron Forchick. Myself as treasurer and fire chief. Captain Dan Leshko. Lieutenant Vincent Chitswara. Second Lieutenants Jim Baddock, Nick Turner, John Herko. Trustees Michelle Hudock, Anthony Vigna, and Andy Ulichny. Our auditor, Mr. Thomas Powell. Yeah. Under our relief association, president is Gary Perna Sr. Vice president, Michael Bowman. Secretary Gary Perna Jr., and Treasurer Lance Fortune. And under the McAdoo Ambulance Association, President Vincent Chitswara, Vice President Gary Perna Jr., Secretary Lance Borchick, myself as the Treasurer, our Captain is Michael Bowman, Chief Medical Officer is Daniel Leshko, and Lieutenant is Ryan Gasper. So, these are the President Officers of the McAdoo Fire Company.
He was right, he didn't need a microphone, huh?
Oh, sorry. I forgot Chief Engineer Gary Perna.
So.
Aerial Foreman Gene McHugh. Sorry.
Are you done?
I'm done now.
Hold on a second. It is really getting hard to stay professional. I mean, I think over the years.
You need a water.
Leon, you're even with it. What's that?
Or a box.
I think over the years, a young man sitting just in front of me in front of the podium, every year smiling as I butchered half the crowd with laughter. It came to my head and thinks how things have gone by this past year. And it's not difficult to pick on this crowd, from commissioners to mayors, representatives, township supervisors over the years, troopers, firefighters, volunteers, and yes, even some guest speakers. Well, as Aaron watches this year from a special seat with his grandfather, I'm not going to let him down. I'll dedicate this program to him in three words: touched by an angel. Now, I'm sure Aaron would believe there's no way in hell Jerry Knowles ran at any point in his career as a firefighter or a police officer. For 35 years, maybe he was talking about mealtime. He was a bar stool guy that fell off the stools with Tommy Slain just in time to get the ass into the truck to get to the fire. So I can't imagine his words and his references saying, "I ran." I think about this year in review. Did you notice, my friend from New York, I did not say an ugly word to anyone. Did you notice the jabs I took here like a man? Short man stand, took them all. Now it's my turn. Married men should learn. There's always a turn in life. You just gotta wait it out. The commissioners keep coming back for more abuse every year. I love it. Only two of them again. Frank will not go out in public with them, that's the truth. Yeah. At the last public event, George asked if he could wrap some leftover dessert up with banana cake and take it home for his wife. And on the way home, Gary and George got an argument because Gary got hungry. And typical George, he wouldn't share. That's a typical Republican screwing the Democrats again. As an election year. If Donald was the third commissioner, we truly would have the Three Stooges. George would be Larry. Think about it. Gary would be Mo. And of course, Donald the Schimpf. You know, I believe this is a great group of commissioners currently serving our county. Even if some believe diapers and politicians, the mayor came up here and for his jabs and shots. And if you notice, he talked to the crowd and looked at me, talked to the crowd and looked at me. And he has a lisp when he talks. Did you notice? That's because if somebody's foot isn't up his ass, it's his foot. And we all know the council members of McAdoo and the Klein Township supervisors only come for the free food and the laugh. They don't give a shit about you. We had a supervisor talk up here 1 year ago. Oh, no. Let's talk about the McAdoo group. Let's start with Vinny the Butcher. This guy will cut up everything from deer to coyote in the state or even in Vegas. Could you just imagine the charges that may have been implemented if they could have caught that bastard stinking up the entire hotel? While him and his dad thought they were going to send this prize package back home in the freezer. I will not let this guy carry my luggage. I don't care when. He's a nut. And then there's Leon, who thinks his inner soles and all of his shoes, including his high heels, make him look like a flashy, good-looking guy. That's because he stood in front of a flashy, good-looking girl trying to buy inner soles in my company. And while Leon was standing in front of her, not even knowing what she was selling, going like this, I walked up beside of her and started screaming at him to get back in the group. He's going back on the bus and going back to the facility. Bobby was bent over backwards laughing, and Leon couldn't even speak. And when he walked away, I said to the girl, he didn't try to take any of your french fries, did he? No. Being with Leon is kind of like being Ralph and Norton on the honeymoon. And he's Norton. Every once in a while, you got to give him that crack in the back of the head to keep him blind in. Patty and Mike, thank you for coming again this year and not taking the taxi, because that guy was a little freaked out. Jimmy Sabatella, are you here? Where are you at, Jimmy? Hi. You're part of the program, right, Jim? Jim's the president of Keystone and working on the merger with the guys. He's our special bug man. And he's going to be part of changing the codes in McAdoo when the consolidation happens so we don't get stuck under any more porches. I have to tell you something. This is a true story. I had the opportunity this year to have some fun and help the McAdoo fundraisers on Super Bowl Sunday. My senior, I want to apologize. Oh my God, I was on frying wings. These assholes can't count. Leon Senior here keeps the things moving. Roseanne was watching to make sure everything was going well in the kitchen. Maddie was passing alcohol shots out to me. Let me tell you, very true story. Mike Severa was in there. Very nice guy. He was helping. And when I left the kitchen, I said, he seems like a nice guy. You guys should get him to join your station. And they said, well, he is a member of our station. He's in here doing some community service. I said, really? What does he do for a living? I said, he's a window washer. Window washer, my ass. He's a peeping Tom. He's back there doing community service. I guess he's good friends with Chester. Where's Chester? By the way, Tresco and Keystone, if you didn't meet Chester, keep your young guys together, please. Don't worry about the girls. He's on the Friars, Tony, Frank, and Leah. Could you imagine? Could you imagine the three of us frying wings? None of us washed our hands. None of us knew what to do when the wings hit the fryer. Were they crispy? Were they raw? Was Bobby still out eating the last batch? They timed everything. No matter what you did, you turned the timer on. Everything works by a timer. I kid you not, this is how paranoid this group is. For years I've come up here, either spoke or received the program. Three or four times in the kitchen I called Maddie Jean. No one corrected her, not even Maddie. Because when you're in their company, they figure, don't give them any more shit to tell them. Don't load the gun. I said to Maddie today, how come you didn't correct me? I don't think I heard you. I said it through. How about another shot? Hey, Gene. Don't want to say a word. On the other side of the engine room was the stromboli maker. How was your stromboli, Jerry?
Good.
Good. Water blue. I had a stromboli also, Jerry. Took it home, cut it right in half. My wife ate half, I ate half. Obviously, Danny and Jimmy were up there, put something in the recipe, because my stromboli wasn't just as good as yours. Julie fell asleep immediately after we ate, and I started getting this weird feeling.
And you got the runs.
4 hours. I'm gonna put my foot up your ass. 4 hours later, it still wouldn't go down. I'm thinking, what the hell did they put my stromboli? Thank God my son went back to college. He didn't have any stromboli. He'd be walking around in Harrisburg with a bunch of flags. Have some stromboli. I don't know how to explain that to his mother. And Trooper Pal, nice to have you back. Seriously, Monsignor told me when he came in, he shook my hand, he says, I'm going straight to hell anyway, it doesn't matter what I say tonight. So, and Kevin did a hell of a job last year, beating you up. You were like the celebrity roast master. It's a fine beating you took and you didn't even take your gun out. Monsignor did say if you take the white tablecloth after this and see him out in the hallway, we'll clean up. Before we get our guest speaker up this year, and he's a nervous wreck, I don't know why. Just give me a little time, I'll come up with some trash on him. I'd like to mention something to me, to you, that puzzled me for the last 2 years now. I have searched many websites and looked in books and even talked to some physicians at work. But I can't find out why Donald has to take a shit after every visit. Every time we eat, every time we pass a restaurant, even on calls on the interstate when he has to run up the mountain. I'd like to start a lottery pool this year to see what Donald's problem is. When he takes that shit, what the time span is, maybe we can start some kind of pool and make a few dollars. This is only the beginning, so I hope you're warmed up. Our guest speaker tonight, Mr. Robert Sarno, Lieutenant of Engine Company 283 of FDNY. He has joined FDNY in 1981 and was assigned to Queens. After 6 months, he was transferred, got a little trouble, then was assigned to Brooklyn and never left. He worked 10 years in 332 engine, East New York. It was a busy shop. He has been a lieutenant since 1991 and been in engine 283 for 21 years. He has been in engine companies his whole career. He reminisces, they pushed a lot of hose down hallways in those years. He was fortunate to be on a job from 1981 to 1984 with his father. His father retired in 1984. He just had 40 years at the Valley Stream Volunteer Fire Department. His dad got him his application, and also for all the young men of the Valley House. Only two went on the job. I am pleased to introduce Lieutenant Sarno, Fire Department of New York.
serious. I'm not a real good public speaker, so I wrote a couple of things down. I'm just going to read them. And thank you for having me tonight. Chief of Department Rob Lesko, officers, members, honored guests, good friends, and of course Tammy. I was asked many months ago to be here tonight. Somehow I said yes, I don't know how. So let me begin with some background on me and how I got here. I'm a 33-year veteran of the New York Fire Department, being a second-generation city firefighter. I have served in many active units throughout my career. My dad served 40 years in the FDNY after coming home from the Second World War. Again, I'm a lieutenant, 21 years in Engine 283 Brownsville, Brooklyn. We have been a top 25 engine company for my entire time. This year we did over 5,000 runs again. And we're number two in the city, going to 122 all-hands fires. I am living a boyhood dream, doing the job I always wanted, hoping it never ends. Having been in active units, I have been vocal with our fire department shops, with the designers, with ideas to improve our pumpers and make them more friendly for our daily use. For over the last 15 years, I have been the senior lieutenant on this design committee. Firefighters, mechanics, and designers all participate to build a better truck, one that stays in service and is usable for the line troops. Bring on Chief Lesko. Last February and March, the FDNY made about four trips to KME as they won the bid for 91 new fire engines. It was a major move as we were switching from a fan favorite Seagrave. On our first trip to Pennsylvania, as part of a nine-man inspection group, we were reviewing the cab and the chassis. I was standing back amazed by the attention the truck was receiving. A lot of visitors were at the KME inspection building, and there was an excitement in the air that I have never seen. I saw this during all my visits to KME. I met Chief Lesko on the first visit there. He was bringing a truck in for service, probably from Hazleton, and he stopped by for a look at our new truck. I knew right away he was a fireman, not a salesman, just the way he acted. We struck up a conversation, and I told him that was probably pretty universal in our fire service. Volunteer or city paid, pro be a senior man, and on the roll, we are all the same. We face the same problems, issues, apprehensions, and fears in the discharges of our duties. While talking to your chief, I felt like I was talking to one of the guys in my kitchen in Brooklyn. We talked about the new KME, about our departments, and about our families. I guess we both have had a rocky road at some point and now realize how important family really is. We are all members of an elite group, everybody here. Only we know the fears of a late night run in the cold winter with reports of people trapped. Only we know the feeling of black smoke on the horizon on a blistering hot summer afternoon. Only we know the horrible feeling of a terrible car wreck with toys in the road. I have been blessed with my career, been very active units, responded to both attacks at the World Trade Center, not knowing after the first one that I was have an eyewitness seat to a terrible tragedy of the worst tragedy of our times. Three men that attended my wedding were killed that morning amongst the hundreds of other victims. I spent close to 2 months assigned to the recovery project at Lower Manhattan. This past fall, I was given a three-month detail to our training center. It was the first time I was offline in 33 years. I think the job was telling me to take a break, a three-month break. They said you have done enough. Don and Tammy came for a visit one rainy day. I gave them a short sort of tour. I was hoping to give them a flavor of the tradition, history, and enormity of the FDNY, a look that most people don't get. It struck me then, we are all the same. We value our jobs, our lives, our families, our friends, and our traditions. We are firefighters. We, as firefighters, are the backbone of many villages, towns, and cities across this country. We love our calling to the fire service to a fault. I am back to the firehouse since January 8th, the day we put our new KME in service. 6 hours and six runs after we went in service, we went to a second long fire. We arrived to find two buildings and a garage fully involved. Not a bad way to start, but in truck.
Good job, Leon.
We are all the same, volunteer, city paid, young, old, probably a senior man. I just like to say, remember this. Take care of your boss. They watch over you with fires. Take care of the brothers. They work hand in hand with you. Take care of the equipment. It could save you some money. Take care of the trucks. You ride them daily. Take care of the mechanics, dispatchers, and housemen. They all matter. Take care of family and of each other. That's all we really have. We have been entrusted with a wonderful calling, even better than when you got here. We will ensure it for our future firefighters. Thank you very much for having me as part of your dinner tonight.
Success in 2014 reflects the support that you have provided, and we thank you for your help. One of our important goals is working toward merging Keystone McAdoo and Fiscal Fire Companies into one department. We are well aware and on our way to bring this to fruition while remembering the heritage of each company. This is the beginning of a new era for our fire companies and the communities we serve. Much of that has been brought into play by some of our local political entities here. We may be the forerunners of us merging down the road somewhere, even police departments or street departments. With your continued support and the grace of God, we will be assured of success. Thank you and have a pleasant evening.
So, in thinking about my little talk here tonight, there was just a couple points that I did want to touch on. The merger, just to bring everybody up to speed where we're going. Presently, McAdoo and Keystone, we've signed our paperwork. Our paperwork has now been filed, waiting for a court date in Schuylkill County to have it accomplished. Both me and the attorney are hoping that by May 1st, at least both of our companies will be together. Our fictitious name paperwork has been filed. So next year, probably, fortunately or unfortunately, this will be the last McAdoo Fire Company banquet. Next year, it will be coming back as KMT, Emergency Services Banquet, which will be our new name. On the Tresco side of it, they're being a little more difficult. Not by the firefighters that are here today, but by the canteen. So they are presently, there was a meeting there on Wednesday night, and everything was pretty much spelled out, which I believe very clearly, to their membership. Thanks, Donald. Anywhere to ding it while I'm talking. So their membership has been advised as to what the options are, whether they're going to voluntarily go with their dissolution, or if it becomes involuntarily, how potentially the Attorney General is going to come in and give them their 50-year colonoscopy. So they may not have much of a choice. So I would firmly believe that we, sometime this year, all three companies will be together. So, and to everybody who has been on those committees, I commend everybody for the time they've taken away from their families to make this happen. As I know, Joe Gusick's had many of talks with me There's been many of nights I've had to calm him down and just have him relax and we'll get through this. And us as a company, the McAdoo Fire Company this year, we've had a lot to get through. Not only as a company, but me personally. As Frank came out and said, we had a great loss this year. Somebody who would have been sitting here with us smiling up a storm, whose smile was contagious, and I mean contagious, and not just to this fire company, but in last weekend when we had the band banquet, for a kid who had a disability, him and all of us never let it stop him. And that's what being a family is about. That is what we all try to do for each other. And I could not be prouder to be fire chief of this company because everybody puts everybody first. And we are family. When we suffered that tragic loss, there was nobody who was not there. There were people who spent days there with us. Tony, Don, Vigna, Leon and Michelle, those people would just, we were there the whole time. They were there literally the whole time. And that's what, in my eyes, being a member of the McAdoo Fire Company and how me and Lieutenant Sarno talked last night, the brotherhood, because we all treat each other like family. It doesn't matter what's happening. You need us, we're there. And that's what we all need to make sure we keep important. Yes, our merger's changing traditions. It's going to change, but you know what? We have the ability to make our own traditions start. And that's what's going to be important. Each and every one of us will be on that top ladder starting this tradition. We'll be able to make tradition even bigger and better and make our residents 100 times safer through everything we do. And I know we all put a lot of time in, but I also don't ask anybody to put any more in than what I put in. And maybe I'm a little psychotic that I put, maybe I'm a little crazy with it, but that's just where it is. That's how I am. That's how I feel about this company. So I will go and say, just in closing, I appreciate everything everybody and everyone in this company does to make us better. And me, Mary Beth, and Robert truly appreciated everything everybody did for us this year. And remember, he's not gone, and don't stop believing.
Looking down at you, and you finally said me instead of I, and I'm so proud of you. Vinny, your favorite part? Are you ready?
Yeah, are you?
Your hands were all blood?
Hands are washed.
As soon as you said wash your hands with blood, see trooper.
This is my area.
Hold that
my area.
Fire, 29 Station 2, 92 Ventana Truck, a shot forward, firing 27.
Another nice job, Vinny. Very touching. And now the banker of the company, Danny Lesko. Year in review. Let's see, we've got the banker, the chief, and Shim.
They put me on a time frame this year. In terms of our activity for the past year, EMS did slightly over 400 calls. Our fire department did over 200 calls. In other terms, is we were basically called out two times almost every single day for a call for assistance. The one thing that we have realized over the past few years is, one, there is nothing routine, and we should not take them as routine. But unfortunately, with all our education, training, knowledge, and everything else, you can never be prepared for what you may respond to. This year was always a first for me in terms of responding to the interstate and not having to extricate a human being. But we had to cut out a horse out of a trailer. And once again, there's no class or knowledge that you can use to cut out a horse. Nick is our resident horse extrication expert now. But the one thing ends up also being is also from that one day, if I could bring it up here quite quickly, is the girl sent us a message. She wasn't from around here or anything else. The one thing ends up that she did acknowledge is that we saved someone in her family. It's what we do every single day. We may not always have the most rudimentary aspects, just as we did a few weeks ago. Our companies were responsible for landing 7 helicopters, as everyone knows. That is my professional line of business. And then speaking with guys, I mean, the one pilot who has been in from the Vietnam era said he has not seen that since the rice paddies when he was actually removing soldiers out of the Vietnam War. And he did acknowledge the effort that was there because, believe it or not, he said that wasn't a simple thing to do off. And this comes from a guy who's been in the air medical business a long time. So the other aspect is, as Frank said, is I do have a hobby that I like to do money. I like to do grants and everything else. We were the recipients over $125,000 in grants this year to our fire company. When we get this grant system, we reinvest it for our future. One aspect that we did do, we put a exhaust capture system to control carcinogens in our station was installed. The other aspect is we bought $80,000 in state-of-the-art rescue tools. We are a $250,000 business, folks. If you like to think that or not, that's where I harp in our meetings and everything else that you'll always hear me bring up about money and everything else. The like it or not aspect ends up being is $250,000 is a lot of money, and we manage this on a regular basis, and each and every one of us do it responsibly. That's why we ensure that we will be around here in the future. In doing so, I'm very proud of where we continue to be in our community. We are definitely laying the blocks of our foundation. We continue to be one of the largest and longest supporters of our Little League baseball system, our recreation system, our Halloween parade. Still, once again, if you drive through the communities, McAdoo, Klein Township, Christmas in our town is, in generally your eyes, because of a lot of people in this room. We decorate the town. We set that memorial wall. You will not believe the number of people that come to me every year and acknowledge what we mean to the community. We're just not firefighters. We are out there. We are a true spirit in our community. And in looking down with this, we are going into an incredible aspect of our future where we're hand in hand, we are walking together not only with the Keystone Fire Company, but the Tresco Fire Company. We acknowledge our political entities. We are working very closely not only from the federal side, the state side, the county side, the local municipalities. We continue to have open communications and once again be forerunners. We are, believe it or not, looked at as our company, despite the fact we come from Little McAdoo, Pennsylvania. I have companies that I work with from Pittsburgh and up around Scranton that try to model their fire companies after us. I work with our congressman on that, and they are coming, and honestly, flattery is presented in one of the greatest impressions by them impersonating you. And there are companies who truly want to impersonate us on a regular basis, and honestly, really, really happy to do that and be honored that somebody wants to be just like our organization. The merger is going to move that forward, and in continuing in doing so, we stand arm in arm, and we are ready for anything that is presented to us. Thank you.
You know what happened the last picture we took on the cell phone. Go ahead. You remember it. Is that it? We're done? All the bullshit's over? We ready to go? Is there any politicians or anybody who would like to take the mic then? Steve. No? Take your time.
Did I say what I said to you when I came in? You could touch me if you want, Steve.
All right, thank you. Sit down. Sit down. We don't want to listen to you. Sit down. Sit down. Thank you very much. Council, you see how you do that?
Right.
I'm not talking to you. Sit down. There's a better part of program.
Sit down.
The well-topped snowbank.
The proctologist called. They found your head.
All right, hold on. Coming up now, or what? Want me to bring everybody up with you?
Whenever you're ready.
You going to speak without the microphone?
As always.
Another. You were dropped. Pat, Benny, Marianne, you're going to join this illustrious quiet son of yours.
The first person we actually have an award for, Bob Sarno, if you'd please come up here. On behalf of the McAdoo Fire Company, we present you with a sweatshirt. So the first award is the Ambulance Award for the Chief Bob Leshko Memorial Award. And that award this year goes to Frank Helmer. As we come up, there's this award and there's also a proclamation from Representative Knowles and Senator Argel, so please take that as you're here.
Ready? One, two.
The McAdoo Fire Company Bob Leshko Memorial Award this year goes to Lance Borchick. Unfortunately, the Bill Riccio recipient is not able to be here with us tonight, which that this year was given to David Fatula. Unfortunately, Dave had to work tonight, so he's unable to be here, so we'll get that to him.
His boss is a real bastard.
That's for Dave.
There you go, Donnie.
You wouldn't let him off.
The McAdoo Fire Company Annual Firefighter of the Year Award for 2014 goes to Nick Turner.
I love it. Nice job, Nick.
Thank you.
Quick picture, picture, picture. One. You hold it, turn it. One.
Give Frank a box.
Who said that?
Okay, this is the President's Award, and this award goes to Robert N. Leschko Sr. for over 20 years of your outstanding dedicated service, commitment, leadership, and compassion, which has guided the growth and success of McAdoo Fire Company. The officers and members express our sincere gratitude for your service. March 7, 2015.
The other ones we have are service awards that we're going to give out over here. So just so as everybody's aware, some of you will be receiving a pin badge for your dress uniforms. So they're not everybody was getting these, but the people who have dress uniforms. So we'll give them out and we'll go from there. There's a stack of people who presently are not here. We'll get them to them as we see them. So we'll start off with, and there may be a couple we forgot, and we will get them to you. We apologize. But some of the new members who came in, we didn't have you on the list we started with. So 2 years of service, Nicole Leschko. Three years of service, Tammy Martin.
One. I'm fast, though. I'm fast. One, two.
2 years of service, Jamie Marjolik. 2 years of service, Mr. Ed, Nick Turner. 2 years of service, Martin McDermott. 2 years of service, Jeffrey Payne. 1 year of service, Jim Hartman. 5 years of service, Whitney Duca. 5 years of service, James Baddock. 5 years of service, Roseanne Vigna. 7 years, Chrissy Chernego.
Right here. Hey.
7 years, Tom Chernego. 7 years, Joanne Breyer.
too? Oh, wait, wait.
7 years, Paulette Polushko. Seven years, Robert Leshko Jr.
Robert!
Monica Sobolewski. 10 years, Robert Bubba Yurcho. You want us to come over there to you?
It's therapy. It's therapy.
10 years, Frank Kellner.
You're built for that, you know.
10 years, Ryan Gasper. 10 years, PJ Matuicha. 10 years, Gary Perna Jr. 10 years, Leon Sobolewski Jr. 10 years, Michael Bowman. 12 years, Joe Gusick. 12 years, Franny Gusick. 11 years, Samantha Chitswara. 17 years, Paula Leshko. 15 years, Kurt McHugh. 15 years. Here's John McNeil. He's in the crowd. I know the feelings.
Did you get permission?
That one. 15 years, Gary Perna Sr. 18 years, Thomas Powell.
18
I'll take my picture, buddy.
One page.
Picture.
One page.
I'll shake your hand. No picture.
No.
Get on the table. 20 years, Donald Leshko. 25 years, Vincent Chitswara. 25 years, Daniel Leshko. 25 years, Anthony Bigman.
Don't let me.
1, 2.
Yeah, we only put them on 5 sometimes. Yeah.
25 years, Mary Beth Leshko.
25 years. Oh, great.
One, two.
There you go. 24 years, Thomas Hudak. Connie, here's Connie. She's not here, so.
Hey, thanks, guys.
Go ahead. 1, 2, nope. So, 1, 2. There you go.
26 years, Michelle Hoover.
It reflects the flag.
30 plus years, Leon Cebulski Sr. 30 plus, Lance Borchick. 30 plus, Eugene McHugh. 30 plus for myself. Seven years, Matthew Sapulich. 48 years, Marianne Leshko. 51 years, Andy Ulichny. 3 Cross Awards, which on 1-9-2014 at 07:41 hours, McAdoo was dispatched for a reported accident with entrapment. 4909 was the first to arrive on scene, reporting a Jeep Liberty on its roof with a female still in the vehicle. Ambulance 920-4915 were to arrive not long after. Upon further investigation, was found that the passenger door needed to be removed in order to remove the patient from the vehicle. Maverick tool from 4915 was used to remove the passenger door. At that time, Medevac 4 was requested to be placed in the air due to mechanism and patient injuries. Route 309 north and south was closed due to allowed a helicopter to land right on the scene. Patient placed on long back four, removed from vehicle, placed in litter, back in ambulance 920, care of patient transferred Medevac crew, patient was transported to Lehigh Valley Cedar Crest, Route 309 open and south, still closed due to tow truck being there. So these are the Green Cross Awards for the people who participated in that extrication. Gary Perna Sr.
Have him stay up there, if he can. Just together.
Michael Bowman, Daniel Leshko, and myself. So, just stay here for the picture. Just stay here
for a group photo. On three, ready?
Smile.
On three, hold on. Hold yours up, hold yours up. On three, ready? One, two, and again, one, two.
You get the hair out of your eyes.
And that is the awards presentation for tonight.
Can we get off, sir? Or is he done?
How about one more round of
All the officers, please come forward. McAdoo Fire Company Incorporated Memorial Resolution. Whereas Aaron M. Lushko, lifelong resident of McAdoo, Pennsylvania, member of McAdoo Fire Company since 2010, entered into eternal rest after a long battle of juvenile band disease on August 18, 2014. Whereas Aaron was a student at Hazleton Area High School, member of the class of 2015, proud honorary member of the Hazleton Area High School Marching Cougar Band, member of St. Michael's Byzantine Catholic Church. He participated in the PA Special Olympics and attended the PA Lions Club Beacon Lodge. Played t-ball for the McAdoo Little League and the Ron Frey Challenger League, along with participating in the McAdoo Winter Basketball League and McAdoo Cub Scout Pack 643. And whereas Aaron was a fine, outstanding young man, he had a tremendous positive impact on all the lives he touched. He was a friend to all, always had a laugh to share, a kiss and a hug to give. In the definition of life, Aaron lived it to the fullest. He was compassionate, kind-hearted, shining star in the eyes of all who loved him and knew him. We pay homage to his life and memory to an outstanding citizen and public servant, a true brother to the fire service who lived with the don't stop believing attitude. Now, therefore, be resolved that McAdoo Fire Company Incorporated expresses sorrow and sense of loss for the passing of Aaron and Lushko to his family, his devoted parents, Chief Robert and Mary Beth Lushko, his dedicated, loving brother, Robert Lushko Jr., and his faithful companion service dog, Kahlua. I present them with a copy of this resolution, and be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution be transmitted and displayed in the halls of the McAdoo Fire Company as evidence of our sincerest condolences on the loss of our brother firefighter, Aaron M. Lushko.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody.
Every year I get in trouble.